guys, it's Beth. Welcome back to my channel. Yeah, I haven't been on here in 2 months, I think, at this point. Yeah, I think my last video is end of March. If you've been wondering where I've been, what happened was when we moved into this apartment, we moved in February, I started getting styes on my right eye, and I don't know why. Like, I would have one, it would get better, it would go away, and then I would get another one, like, you know, about a week or two later. So that went on for, I would say, probably about 6 or 7 weeks. And then also during that time, on March 23rd, I adopted my puppy. His name is Travis. He is a blue heeler mix. He was 6 months old when we got him, so he turns 8 months today, actually. Wait, no, it's today the 24th. I don't remember what day it is, actually. I think it's the 24th. But yeah, so we share a birthday because his... since he's 6 months old in March, that is 6 months from my birthday, which is September 23rd, so we have the same birthday, which is awesome. But yeah, so that's where I've been. Yeah, I just wanted to pop on here and talk about makeup, because I haven't talked about makeup with anybody but my best friends in a while, so here I am. So I thought we would talk about new makeup releases, because I haven't done a video like that. I used to have a written blog, and I did do like anti-hauls and stuff on there, but I haven't done one video-wise. I did start a new blog and a new Instagram account, so I will link both of those down below if you want to check them out. You don't, totally don't have to, but yeah, I post most of my makeup looks on my Instagram account, so there's that. Okay, so the first thing that I wanted to talk about was ColourPop, of course. So ColourPop has come out with their birthday collection, because May is their birthday month, and I don't know how I feel about this. The thing is, like, I love their little monochromatic palettes. I have the green one, the purple one, and the pink one. And the pink one's actually my least favorite out of all of those. I think the green one is my favorite. And, you know, I was like, I really want red, I want yellow, and I want blue. Like, those are the three other colors that I need. Like, well, I don't need them, but I want them. Like, I want them really bad. And so I saw this palette, and I was like, oh my god, they came out with a red palette. And then I started looking at it closer, and I'm like, why is this the same shade repeated 9 times? Or, like, you know, I'm just like, I don't need 9 shades of the same shade of red. It's not great, it's not a gradient, but they didn't do that. Just that center row is shimmers, I believe, because I'm not looking at the photo right now, but I just don't like it that much. And then also, this entire theme of this collection is watermelons, right? And it's a watermelon themed palette. It's called Watermelon Squeeze, I'm pretty sure. There's no green in this palette, there's no white in this palette, and there's no black in this palette, which are the other colors of a watermelon. And they also could have added a yellow in there, because watermelons come in red and gold. Could have happened, but they didn't do it. So I'm just like, I don't need it. I don't think anybody else needs it. If you want to get it, like, go ahead, but you don't need it. Every single look that you come out, that you do, is just gonna come out the same, so there's no point. And the next thing from ColourPop that came out, launched today, and I already bought it because I have no self-control, is the Blue Moon palette. And like I was talking about the red palette not having a gradient, this has a gradient. I love it. Like, I need it. I want it so bad. I'm gonna say this right now. I'm like teeter-tottering about whether or not I support Jeffree Star Cosmetics. Like, I'm like, right now, I have never bought anything from Jeffree Star. When the Blue Blood palette came out, I was like, holy shit, I want that so bad. And I didn't buy it. My best friend got it and she loves it, but I haven't purchased it. I don't think it's restocked. And then when I saw this palette, I was like, hell yeah, I'm gonna get that and save myself like 50 bucks, you know? So I would rather get a formula that I know and I trust instead of a formula that I haven't tried that is very, very expensive to me. And also just with all the crap with Tarte and, you know, James Charles and all that, I'm just like, I don't know how I feel at the moment. So I haven't really talked about it too much on my channel, but I support indie brands like a ton. Like, I love indie brands. My next video, I'm probably gonna be wearing the same outfit and same makeup, because I'm probably just gonna film it right after this, but it's gonna be an indie makeup haul, because I have a shit ton of indie makeup that I have not shown on this channel. I have posted it on my Instagram, but I have not filmed a video with it or talking about it, so we'll get into that. But the first thing I wanted to talk about is the Midas Cosmetics Flower Bomb Palette. I have also purchased this palette and it's on its way to me. I should have it by Tuesday. I'm probably going to film a 3 looks 1 palette and review video with that palette because it is beautiful. It is the most beautiful spring palette I have ever seen in my entire life, and I saw it and I was like, I don't need another palette, but I'm getting it. Like, that's what happened. If you don't like pressed glitters, like, there's like 6 of them in there, I think, you're not gonna like, I'm not gonna say that you're not gonna like this palette. I'm just gonna say you probably won't like these shades individually, but like, I have one pressed glitter. It's also in an indie brand palette. Let me grab it. I have one pressed glitter and it's in the Luscious Luxe Cosmetics Pretty Girl Squad palette that looks like this. And it is the shade down here, Classy AF. And I actually really like it. I have been playing with glitter lately and I actually really like glitter. So, and I feel like pressed glitters are a lot easier to apply because they have a tackiness since they have a gel in them to keep them, you know, adhered to the pan and then on the eye. So I don't really know why everybody's like shitting on them because I think they're pretty great, but that's just me, whatever, you know. And then also Luscious Luxe Cosmetics actually came out with 2 palettes recently, and I don't remember what they're both called. One of them is called Pastel Potion. Palette, and that one, when I get paid again, I'm getting that palette. I absolutely love this brand. I need to do a brand review because I have so much stuff from this brand. They're really, really affordable. The girl that does it, she lives in Texas, which, like, you know, home state, gotta support home state. So yeah, I really like her makeup. If you've noticed that my middle finger is messed up on this hand, my dog actually broke my finger a few weeks ago and it's still healing, so that's why it looks nasty and I'm sorry, but yeah. Next thing I wanted to talk about, Jaclyn Hill is coming out with her cosmetics line, finally. It's been a while. She's been teasing this for a long, long time. And it's nude lipsticks, and like, a lot of people are not like too happy that that's what she's coming out with, but like, for me, I'm just like, okay. You know, I don't really watch a ton of her videos. I'm not a huge Jaclyn Hill fan, but I have watched a few, and I know that she always says that she can never find a nude lipstick that's like the perfect shade for her lips. So I think that's actually pretty smart and like safe to come out with a nude lipstick first. And it's not just one lipstick, there are multiple shades, it's a whole collection. I think that's actually a really good way to get people that maybe have the same issue to come and, you know, try your brand. Like, I think it was a smart business decision on how my mind works. I think it was smart. Other people may not think so, but I think it is. The Jaclyn Hill lipsticks will be retailing for $18, which I don't think is not too bad. Anastasia's like 20 to 25, I think. So, and then like lower end lipsticks, drugstore, depending on the brand, is like $5 to $10. So I don't think it's too bad. It's about mid range, so it's fine. Ace Boutte also came out with another palette, which I'm on the fence about it because I bought the Blue Moon palette from ColourPop today. So I don't really think that I need this, but like, I like it. Like, I think it's pretty. It is called the Oceanic palette. I think it's pretty. I can totally see that it is truly a ocean inspired palette because they have blues, they have greens, they have like a little bit of a muddy looking brown in there, like very much ocean. Like, I like it. I think it's pretty. Another thing that is coming out is the new Tarte like rainbow palette thing. I don't remember what it's called. I'll insert the name here on the screen. But it is in collab with somebody and they are donating their proceeds to the Trevor Project, which is a charity that I believe donates money to LGBTQ+ people that are under the age of 25 for suicide prevention, I'm pretty sure is what it was. And I think that's absolutely phenomenal. Like, that's great. And this palette is just a little rainbow palette. It's one of their smaller ones. It's going to be $24. I may actually wind up buying this. Like, Tarte has not come out with anything that I have wanted in a very long time. So we all know the whole foundation shade debacle was in 2018, like very beginning of 2018. And I said that I was not supporting Tarte Cosmetics anymore about that because I am very passionate about racial inequality and just it's not fair to people of color that they cannot find their own foundation shade that they need. Like, it pisses me off, quite frankly. So I said I wasn't going to support Tarte anymore. They have like come out with a different foundation since then, and they did not do the same thing. They didn't have a repeat. They actually did okay. They did pretty decent on the shade range, but even before then, Tarte really hadn't come out with anything that I liked. And then, you know, the Icy Beige palette came out, and I was like, nah, like, it's okay. If they had come out with the palette that they had originally shown, I probably actually would have purchased it. Palette may actually be the thing that makes me purchase from Tarte again. I'm still trying to decide if I should, but I don't know. I might wait to see how the reviews come because I don't want to spend money on it and it not be good, because when I still did use Tarte, their quality was always very much hit or miss, and I don't want to spend that much money even though it's not like a ton of money, but you know what I mean. Can we just talk about Too Faced for a second? So they're coming out with this palette and it's called Shake Your Palms, I believe. This is literally if they took the Sweet Peach palette and just like knocked it down to six shades. It's just so boring. It's boring. Like, if you want to keep people buying your stuff, like, don't come out the same thing over and over again. Like, it's not a good business move on your part. And then they're also coming out with this highlighter palette that's like ice cream highlighter palette. I actually really like this. I know that a lot of people said that they don't appreciate this, but I like highlighter palettes. I only have one, and it's the Anastasia Beverly Hills Sugar Glow Kit, and I love that highlighter palette. The only shade that I couldn't use in there was like the top right hand side shade. I don't remember what it's called, but actually, funny enough, when I got it, I had ordered it online from Ulta. That shade came shattered, so I couldn't use it. It was too dark for me anyway, and then, you know, didn't get to use it at all because it was broken, so that was fine. But yeah, I think that this is nice. I for sure can use the white shade, and I can use the pink shade, and then like the dark shade for deeper skin tones, I can use it as an eyeshadow. That's not a big deal to me. I think that highlighter palettes are pretty good because, I mean, if you are darker, I feel like you can mix the shades together and just use it that way. I don't think it's a waste of money necessarily. And like, if you're a makeup artist, then you have something that you can use on everybody for the most part. Thing that they're coming out with is the new mascara, and it's called Damn Girl. Damn girl. Like, I just want to know who is here naming all of Too Faced's products. I saw the brush for this. This looks identical to the Better Than Sex mascara wand, just like not as thick. Like, it's a thinned out version. But can you imagine just like walking around with this on your eyes and then somebody be like, what kind of mascara are you wearing? And you're like, oh, I'm wearing Damn Girl by Too Faced. Like, I can't. I don't even like whenever people, if I'm wearing Better Than Sex, I don't like telling people I'm wearing Better Than Sex because they're just like,
what?
Like, if they're not into makeup, they have no idea what you're talking about and you just feel awkward and I hate
something
it.
Something that came out that's already like, it's not a new release, it's already like being sold. Are these Cover FX like blush duos? I want these so bad. Like, they have a pink one, and I was going to go buy it today. Like, I was fully prepared to purchase it. I texted my best friend and I was like, hey, should I get this because I fucking love it? And she was like, oh. And then we were both like, oh, It's sold out.
I love luminous blushes. Like, one side is matte and the other side's like more sparkly, luminous. Like, I love those. My other favorite blush shade is Milani Luminoso. Like, I love glowy blushes. I like glowy skin. I like dewy skin. I'm not a matte bitch. Like, I'm just not. As soon as this comes back in stock, I'm getting it. I may buy another one too, because I like the peachy color. I like the mauve color. I like every single shade of this blush that they came out with. It's just that not all of them are suited for my skin tone, which is fine. Like, totally fine. Love them. But I don't know. Maybe in the summer when I get tanner. I guess it's summer now. Maybe when I actually get a tan, I could use some of the other shades, but who knows. And the last thing that I wanted to talk about is the new Anastasia Beverly Hills collection with, is her name Alyssa Edwards? I'm sorry, I'm not into, like, drag stuff. I haven't watched RuPaul and Drag Race before, so I'm not really into drag queens, so I'm so sorry if I got her name wrong or anything like that. That is my fault, totally, but you know, her new palette that is coming out looks a lot like the Rivera palette that just came out a few months ago. So I'm probably not gonna buy this, most likely. I didn't buy Rivera. The only like Anastasia palette that I own right now is Sultry, because I declared my Modern Renaissance and I have not purchased any other one that she has done. And the reason why I bought Sultry is because I thought it would be good in case I wind up having to do makeup on other people, because it's a good neutral palette, and the like shimmer and metallics are absolutely beautiful. They're very, very pigmented and it is a nice palette, and I'm glad that I got it. Also, it was on sale. But yeah, I don't have any need for this palette. I think it's nice, but it's just that I have the same shade over and over again. But I love the packaging. Like, that hot pink packaging is great. So I mean, if you want to support her, like, go ahead. Like, you do you. But yeah, I personally probably will not buy this. I might wind up buying it. I don't know, I'm indecisive. Okay, so that is everything for this video, and I will hopefully see you here again very, very soon. So I will talk to you guys later. Bye.